Is that a song? It had a lot of verses to it.
Yeah.
I don't know. You better spell it.
G
A L Gal S A G A L A T I O N Galatians. Oh, you're giving me a verse.
Oh.
Not a song. Okay. Galatians what? 2? Okay. Remind me. I maybe I can pick up on it now. Galatians chapter 2, that I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, but not I, but Christ that lives in me, in him. And you know what, I've witnessed that. Other people say that to us, but many times when he just cannot go anymore, I say, but we told, you know, we said we were going to be there, we're going to, he will allow God to quicken him, and he really doesn't feel like it. But in obedience, he goes, you know, and then in the going, God does strengthen him. And then it works out that he does fine. And we get back and we go, wow, we wouldn't have gone. But judging by the way you seem to have be, you know, feeling, but because we knew that God commissioned us to go, then in the going, he strengthens. Did you have something you were saying? W. We went to Phoenix. March, April, last week in March of last year, 2010, and we were gone for 10 days. And this was on the, it worked out that it was the anniversary of his 1 year from his trach surgery.
Yeah.
And I mean, we didn't know that he wouldn't survive the trach surgery.
Drive.
Yeah, we drove down there. And it took us 3 days, two nights. So it was a lot of work because we had a lot of stuff to bring into the hotel and out again. And you know, and he didn't carry any of it. I did have a daughter with me on the way down and on the way back. But you know, we just really knew that we were to go. And, you know, we look back and we go, wow, you know, how did that even happen? But we're planning to go again. And it seems like, are you crazy? Well, yeah, I guess so, because we're going to, I mean, we don't just on the whim think we should go do these things, but if we feel that God is urging us to do something, then we'd rather do that than forfeit what was there for us to find out that, you know, he has for us, so.
And what is hope? You guys are on 1 hour with Top Show. And what is hope in this situation? How are we going to define hope in this situation? We're dealing with this ALS right now.
Believing for the impossible. That's hope. And, you know, I always think about the verse that says that, you know, God's given us a future and a hope. And, you know, hope for our future. Like, why do we feel like that can be robbed from us when there's given, you know, a diagnosis? And, you know, the enemy wants to rob, kill, and destroy. And he wants to take away your very life that you're given today. So why do we allow him to have that power and influence over us? He doesn't have dominion over that because it's been paid for. Like, we can live in a resurrected life. We don't have to, where there is a victory, we don't have to say, you know, this is the end. You know, there is nothing for my future because it's so bleak. But you just be surprised as you lend your life to God that He, you know, will work in and through you, and take you to places that, and take you to places and on in different adventures that you would never have thought were possible.
And have the relationships that that you have with friends change in dealing with this ALS disease?
Yeah. Well, of course, people are in our culture are very busy, and it takes time to visit with Scott because you have to be very patient. And we appreciate you all coming today,
you know,
because
often, right?
Well, it's just you know, we're not that happening people. You know, we're not going out to dinner, and we're not going on a cruise. We're not doing these things that people might like to do, or meet one another out places. We're actually kind of shut in much of our day. And as I mentioned, I work downstairs, so I'm like here 24/7.
Yeah.
And but so our relationships have changed because people are you know, busy with their own lives, work, families, and we are too. So that's.
You've highlighted a lot of things that are happening, and are there any positive aspects, you know, as you live with this disease, looking from outside like us? You know?
Well, there's many.
Okay.
But I mean, I feel like our relationships are deeper. I feel like our walk with God is deeper. There's truths that we learned, you know, over decades of actually theology, you know, things that we've known. We've been through Bible school, but you can know things up here, but not necessarily here in your heart. And then you go, well, systematic theology, you know, I don't know if I agree. But really, it's simple. It's the gospel of good news that Christ came and He died and He gave His life a ransom for us. And, you know, we're set free. And it's a simple message that we can commit our lives to Jesus, our Savior. And then through Him, we can have the comfort and of a future and a hope. We can have a hope for eternity. And we don't have to strive in the flesh to be good enough, to perform, to know enough. You know, we can just rest in our relationship with Christ. And that, I think, is bigger than we even know, just to be able to trust Him for our breath, just trust Him with our lives. And so the positive aspects are a deeper walk with Christ, I would have to say. And just knowing that when things look bleak, it's not over yet. It's not over until God says it's over. And He numbers our days. And no man, no doctor, no one can project that to you, you know. And so we don't know how many days each of us have. So we have to redeem the time. We have to make the most of each day.
Has that been a book you've read, a conversation, you know, you've had, or a person you've met that made a difference in your life, Scott?
Yes. Oh, our friend Natalie Nichols. She is a, she has had chronic Lyme disease, and she introduced us to a preacher man that she listened to and received much encouragement from. His name was Manly Beasley from Texas. He was like a revivalist. But he also withstood decades of physical illness, but had amazing faith. And she is the same, like she overcomes much during her day and the years that we've known her. Her website is Shades of Grace Ministries. But what she brought to light for us was a problem that it seems to be, you know, many Christians face, that when you're so occupied with that you believe that God can heal. So I believe that God can heal, and I believe he could heal me, but what do you do if he didn't heal you today? You know, like, are we just going to be so consumed with the healing that we can't really, praise him today? Or it's just so consumed, because what if it's years, as it has been, you know, from some of our Bible figures, you know, like years before a promise came to pass? Well, okay, so we believe God, the healer, we know he can heal, but we don't know what his plan is or his timing. So what are you going to do in that space of time? And I think that in some Christian thought is that you don't have faith if you're not like really working toward that healing. But it's not true. You have to be at rest that God, you know, God can do that work, but it's in his hands.
So how will you encourage someone diagnosed with ALS not to be discouraged?
Just to be in the Word of God, to draw near to God and his word. To believe God over what you hear.
And Glennis, how long did it take you to be able to understand? And how do you figure out this? Because I don't know how you do it. Like, the way he's talking, and you're able to get whatever he's saying.
I don't always get it right. He thinks I ad lib some, but we've been married 27 years next month, and. You know, I know him very well, and we have fellowship together. We hear the same messages together. You know, I share books I'm reading with him. Like, so I know him well. So that's part of it. And I'm used to hearing him, so I don't get it right many times. But then he also will spell with his feet if I need more clarification. And when he's in by his computer, He will type it on the Word document or whatever, anything he wants to tell me.
Thank you guys so much, Glennis and Scott Brodie, for this great opportunity to be able to share your story. And I'm sure all of us have learned a lot about you guys. And we're going to keep praying, and you know, someday that the healing will come, okay?
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you, Glennis. Until next time, please don't give up hope. Thank you.